Claudius Francis said he was bewildered by the unnamed commissioner's criticisms of Parliament, which met on Tuesday to debate the very report.
None of us is above criticism or beyond reproach. But it cannot be that a member of a commission charged by this very body to provide us with a report could use such intemperate language when addressing what was said by members of Parliament. He ought to have left such causticity to members of the press and members of the public. His criticism is even more bewildering, bizarre even, when one considers his own contribution to the report.
Independent Senator Stephen King welcomed what the Senate president viewed as dissenting views, suggesting that they contribute to a final document that more accurately reflects and takes into consideration a wider cross-section of views. Leader of Government Business Senator Victor Philip Lecorbinier welcomed the opportunity a revised constitution would present for the masses to have a greater say over important issues.
It cannot be said that the general citizenry had an impact on the shaping of our independent constitutions. So it's not just a question of having these town hall meetings and so on and having even discussions, but does our citizenry have an impact on the constitutional reform process, on shaping our constitutions? And I will say that in the past, that has not been the case. Our constitutions are the products of a colonial empire with a splattering of inputs from national political elites, and in some instances, the forced hands of legislative drafters. Consequently, constitutional reform offers our countries an opportunity to get it right.
Government Senator Dr. James Fletcher had one major criticism of the report. According to him, there were two major errors committed in putting together the commission: the absence of a former politician and a former public servant.
I think had there been a former politician, not a current politician, but a former politician, then there were many of these back then to choose from. Somebody who would not look at this through a colored lens, but who would look at it from the operations of Parliament and the operations of a cabinet. He or she could have guided some of these discussions. So somebody like a Geraldine Rock or someone like that, I think, could have added a different flavor and a different interpretation of some of the comments that were coming back from the members of the public.
The over 300-page report contains in excess of 190 recommendations. Parliament will meet again on the 25th of August to continue its debate of the contents. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.